I've always had a fascination for computers and technology, and I made a few apps for the iPhone, iPod Touch, and iPad. I'd like to share a couple with you today. My first app was a unique fortune teller called Earth Fortune that would display different colors of Earth depending on what your fortune was. And my favorite and most successful app is Bustin Jeiber, which is a Justin Bieber whack-a-mole. I created it because a lot of people at school disliked Justin Bieber a little bit, so I decided to make the app. So I went to work programming it, and I released it just before the holidays in 2010. A lot of people ask me, how did I make these? A lot of times it's because the person who asked the question wants to make an app also. A lot of kids these days like to play games, but now they want to make them. And it's difficult, because not many kids know where to go to find out how to make a program. I mean, for soccer, you could go to a soccer team. For violin, you could get lessons for a violin. But what if you want to make an app? And the kids' parents might have done some of these things when they were young, but not many parents have written apps. Where do you go to find out how to make an app? Well, this is how I approached it. This is what I did. First of all, I've been programming in multiple other programming languages to get the basics down, such as Python, C, Java, etc. And then Apple released the iPhone, and with it, the iPhone Software Development Kit. And the Software Development Kit is a suite of tools for creating and programming an iPhone app. This opened up a whole new world of possibilities for me. And after playing with the software development kit a little bit, I made a couple apps. I made some test apps. One of them happened to be Earth Fortune. And I was ready to put Earth Fortune on the App Store. And so I persuaded my parents to pay the $99 fee to be able to put my apps on the App Store. They agreed, and now I have apps on the App Store. I've gotten a lot of interest and encouragement from my family, friends, teachers, and even people at the Apple Store, and that's been a huge help to me. I've got a lot of inspiration from Steve Jobs. And I started an app club at school, and a teacher at my school is kindly sponsoring my app club. Any student at my school can come and learn how to design an app. This is so I can share my experiences with others. There's these programs called the iPad Pilot Program, and some districts have them. I'm fortunate enough to be part of one. A big challenge is, how should the iPads be used, and what apps should we put on the iPads? So we're getting feedback from teachers at the school to see what kind of apps they'd like. When we design the app and we sell it, it will be free to local districts and other districts that we sell to. All the money from that will go into the local ed foundations. These days, students usually know a little bit more than teachers with the technology. So, sorry. So this is a resource to teachers, and educators should recognize this resource and make good use of it. I'd like to finish up by saying what I'd like to do in the future. First of all, I'd like to create more apps, more games. I'm working with a third-party company to make an app. I'd like to get into Android programs.